everybody, I am Nico D. So today I'm back at Banana Pi M20. So I reviewed this board previously. I wasn't very amazed by it. Certainly the heat conditions are very bad with it. So it is a quad core at 1.2 GHz, but without a good fan you cannot use it at the maximum at 1.2 GHz. There were many problems with the software for this board. So this is a Banana Pi board. The makers of this board, Synovoip, they don't care about software. They don't support any software developers. So the software you get are all from the community themselves. So people at home who build images for these boards. So that means there are a lot of problems. I had bought this board a long time ago to make a handheld out of it. Then it wasn't possible. There was a version of RetroPie. But in that version of RetroPie you could not use sound, so I really needed sound for that to work. So I gave up on the project, I put it away. Now my colleague Christopher from Explaining Computers also made a video about it. And so I thought, why not take it out and see how well it is right now. So I found Retro Orange Pi for it, and that runs really great on it. It even runs PlayStation games and some Nintendo 64 games. So I am amazed about the gaming performance of this board. So now sound works, everything works as it should be. Not all games are emulated as it should. Sometimes there is a sound problem, but many games do work as they should. Certainly, for example, Tony Hawk 2. I would not have expected to play Tony Hawk 2 on this without any frame drops. So that is really great. So now I can use a 3.5 inch display. So just connect that, so with an adapter of course. So where's the display port? Here's the display port, and that goes together like so. And like that, you've got a handheld gaming device. So this display displays at 1080p. So that's great for gaming. It's also 60 frames per second, so you couldn't have any better display for gaming than that. So you could even make a case for it. You could even put some power banks right next to it for power. Then you have a really great on the road do-it-yourself game station handheld. So again, this board does have many problems. It overheats very quickly. I just don't care. I did put a heatsink onto it. It would be better with a much bigger heatsink if you want to play good games, because it will throttle, but I just don't care. It's just a test for me. Maybe later in the year I will make a full handheld out of this, where I can put this right on top of a controller. So I'm gonna show you the gameplay on it. I'm gonna show you how to play on this small display. And here we go! So first of all, we need to download Retro Orange Pi. So we download it at this link. Only this link works. If you search for it in Google, you will get a link that doesn't work. So go to this link. I will give the link in the description of this video also. So just download it and burn it onto an SD card. So here I am in Orange RetroPie. So first thing I'm gonna test is Mega Drive, California Games. I didn't know what I had to do on the halfpipe, so this didn't really work for me, but the game does work well. Like, this game does work, but it is also very hard. Of course, I must show you Sonic of the Master System, one of the best games ever made, of course. Here is Wipeout for the Nintendo 64. It isn't perfect, it's almost playable, but it isn't there. But I am amazed that the Banana Pi M20 can do this. Here F1 Racing Championship for the Nintendo 64. So to start, it lags a lot, but when you start playing, it starts playing a lot better. This is playable for me, I could play this for hours. Now on to the PlayStation. So this is Test Drive 6. I hate this game, but it does run very well. All PlayStation games seem to run very well. Here is Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2 for the PlayStation. It runs perfect. I've played it a lot. It really runs smooth. So now we've seen that the Banana Pi M20 can game quite well. So now I'm going to show you how to put it all together with a small screen. So I'm using long cables, that's no good. Best is to use short cables and a power bank. This is just an example. So we need an adapter from HDMI to mini HDMI. There is a 2.5mm audio jack on the display for sound, so you can use headphones with it. Also an OTG cable from micro USB to USB female. We connect it all. So the power goes into the display. You could power it with the pins, but then you will have to make some wires to go from the 5V and the ground to the right position. But then you only need to power the Banana Pi M20. So all that's left is to power the M20. As you see, the display works. And also the controller. So the final test against Sonic, and it really plays very well. It is a very nice experience to play with this. You can use sound with headphones. This display really works very well. I've got another one of these, also an HDMI display. Should be the same, but this one has got a lot better picture. These displays come from AliExpress. They cost about 10 euros or maybe $15. I used to use the Raspberry Pi 2B as a handheld. I think I'm now gonna replace it with this. So that's it for today. I hope you'll like my video. Subscribe to my channel. See you later. Bye.